starts with a plastic razor. Cool, like Steve McQueen. Look out for the lookers, honey, cause that's entertainment to me. Be a part of the solution. Everybody wants someone to tell them what to do. I know, I do, yeah. Give the people what they want. Yes, it's something that makes you feel so fine. Give them cake and candy for the kids. Feed them all. Everybody's getting away with it. I don't care as long as it gets me back on the stage. Trying to make me happy, being something I can't be. I can't fill this empty hole. I don't care. I gotta get it together.
Sweetwater,
ready
dude.
To go to Boise.
Right? Watching some tennis. Solo tennis.
Yeah.
You're rad, dude.
All right.
What's up, Adam? Rock and roll. Good morning, dude.
What's up, Russ?
What room is Credo in? 211?
Did you check that jacuzzi last night or what?
What?
Did you check that jacuzzi last night or
no,
what?
I missed it, man. Rock and roll, man. Good morning, rock and roll boys. Dude, how you guys doing? The rock and roll lifestyle, man, here in Oregon.
I feel really good today, man. I feel like we've got a nice show tonight in Boise. Last night was great.
Yeah, we got some shit going down.
Same morale is high.
Hey, Credo, how am I doing on the tour so far?
Russ, you're doing good, my friend. You're a rock machine.
That's rad.
Idaho girl, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You ever heard of fucking Idaho?
The Idaho.
That's right, my friend.
Her name's Ida, huh? Her first name?
Her first name's Ida and her last name's Ho. Let's
go wake up Adam. Good morning, rock and roll again.
Good
Good morning.
Adam, you're all rad, dude. You're fucking on tour, dude. Look at that.
Yeah. Where's Katie?
Come on, Linda. Come on, Linda. Oh, you ready for some Idaho's tonight, buddy?
Yeah.
Yeah. What up,
dude? You guys getting some
Idaho's? Yeah.
Look at that.
Jesus Christ, that thing looks insane.
That's from the show last night from Credo's mic falling on my face.
Punk rock director Rusty Pelican, age 30.
These are mine. I went home and I found my great sunglasses for one day, and then I spent 9 more days trying to find them again.
Hey, Cole, introduce yourself and what you do for your band, what you are.
My name is Cole Peterson. I play bass for Sweetwater, and these are my new sunglasses.
And your new friends.
And my new friends.
Okay, let's see. Basically, you know, we've grown up, we've known each other for since we were like 7 years old. Went to school together, and in the history of the band is we just started rocking in the basement of, Cole's basement, the top floor of this guy named Jeremy Rudo's house. You know, chilling around with the black lights and, you know, sniffing the Jack Daniels and...
This way, it's like, this, if anybody out there listening, it's, we all get it. It's like you're just like saying words. Started Cole's basement.
Words have the power to change the universe.
It's so great.
What is power?
You know, we just started in the attic sniffing the whiskey.
And it just kind of, you know, snowballed from there. Yeah,
snowballed.
It's just a lot of spicy crispy chicken, you know, and it's all good times. But, basically, Credo was opening up the Sonic Youth and shit.
Teriyaki chicken, you know, the kid, life ain't that bad.
He blew up his amp and then tried to sell it to me for $300, which of course I bought it.
And that's the history of the band.
Dick Credo, he's like a used car salesman.
Yeah, I got some lakefront property in Idaho that I'm trying to sell.
Idaho? You know.
Make you come back again. Time to do yourself in.
Chablis and the hand-rolled cigarette?
Okay, I gotta sip that.
No, there's no prerequisites. We're kind of filling our requirements as we go along.
That's
kind of been the name of this game.
Sure.
We lack in talent, we make up for it in, you know, integrity.
You are a bad.
Meet you at a quarter to ten. Just another night to do yourself in.
Basically, we're, you know, it's going really well. It's going better than it ever has, Melanie. We've each had secret meetings about kicking the other member out. And, you know, somehow we can never get a majority together. It's sort of like a hung jury.
Because we're worried about the riots.
Yeah, exactly. We're worried about the riots that ensued in Seattle after.